How can we control prosthetic hands? Think about all the things that you can do with your hand, all the different movements it can make, and the challenges we face as engineers when we're designing a hand for someone who was born without one or who may have lost one in an accident. There are different options, but there's usually a trade-off between function and appearance. This is a passive hand, it doesn't move. You might choose something like this if you wanted a lifelike solution. They can be used to stabilise objects and they're nice and light. For people looking for function, we have what we call active prostheses. These tend to be less aesthetic, but they can open and close, allowing you to pick up and manipulate objects. There are two key ways they can be controlled. One is a mechanical solution, which uses a cable attached to other parts of the body to pull against a spring, in this case, an elastic band. The forces can have an impact on the rest of your body, but these are simple and intuitive. The other is an electrical solution with a motor and batteries, which work using the electrical signals generated by your muscles. These are the most advanced solution, but they take a bit of training to learn to use.